let's take a look at the dashboard of your projects in HubMeta. I'm going to open an existing project so that it has some information in it already. So in this dashboard, what you see in the middle is the main information about your project. This is, for example, the PRISMA chart, which shows all the different steps in the selection process for your articles and your projects. So in this project, for example, this is the number of records from different databases. This is the number of records after duplicates are removed. This is basically my Titan and Abstract screening process where this number of records were screened and this number of them were rejected, and these are the reasons for them being rejected. Down here, this is the results of my full text screening, so 1500. So this number of full texts were actually assessed for eligibility and this number of them were found not suitable for my project, and these are the reasons for that. And this is the final set of studies that were included in my meta-analysis, and you can of course download this chart, and this is how it looks, which can be used in your final version of your paper. Now here you can see the contribution of different collaborators in your project in the different parts of your project, and this is the number of variables that you have, different types of variables, which we'll explain later. So on the left, you have a sidebar, which is basically a timeline for your project. You start by importing articles from different databases. Then you do title and abstract screening. Then you do full text screening. And then you manage the taxonomy of your project, basically different measurements and constructs that would be used in your analysis. Then you do your data entry, in which you actually code relevant data from all the papers that you have included in your project. And finally, after that, you're ready to do your meta-analysis. So up to this point, from overview to data entry, is the same for systematic reviews and meta-analysis. After this point, you can choose this export function to take all the information you have up to this point out of HubMeta to do your analysis elsewhere. Or if you're doing a meta-analysis, you can of course do your calculations here on HubMeta. Next, we'll talk about collaboration on HubMeta.